Greetings to all subscribers. And so we're doing another video, and this one is going to be called Two Salvations. How many of you know that there are more than one types of salvation spoken of in the Bible? I actually didn't know that myself until about a year or so ago when I heard it in a teaching and I began to look into it. And I learned a lot about it. I don't think it's something that's taught very much, and I can understand why it is. It's because it pretty much undermines some of the works salvation gospel teachings or the Arminian gospel, because it points out the sovereignty of God in eternal salvation. So we will talk about eternal salvation, and we will talk about temporal salvation. Eternal salvation, of course, is salvation that started outside of time and it will exist after time ends. And temporal salvation is salvation that starts in time and it will end in time as well. So let us look into this, but this is just going to be an overview because there's a lot to it. There's a lot of scriptures I could share, and I won't have time to do it in this video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to recommend, if you are interested in the subject, that you watch a teaching video by Pastor James L. Henderson out of the Lakeland Church in Florida. And the name of that video is Temporal Salvation, and I will link that video. Also, there's an article that was written by elder and pastor from the Primitive Baptist Church in Calabash, North Carolina. And let's see, the name of that one is Temporal Salvation, a Bogus or Biblical Concept. And so, okay, let us start. We're going to look at a definition of eternal. We will start with eternal and then we'll talk about temporal. Eternal, infinite in past and future duration without beginning or end in time. So, if someone were to ask, when were you saved, if you are one of God's elect, and you would give a date, as I would have, that being October the 10th, 1973, in Hilo, Hawaii, about 8 o'clock at night. That's what I always used to tell people. Well, I've discovered over the years that that's not necessarily true. It's true in the sense of I can point to a time when I was converted by hearing the gospel. I was converted in my mind, but I was actually a believer before that happened because I had to have been a believer to believe the gospel. And so, how was one saved in eternity? Well, one is saved in eternity if he is an elect of the Lord by being chosen by the Father. Now, there's a covenantal agreement within the Godhead. The Father chose an innumerable amount of people from every tongue, tribe, and nation throughout all of time that would be saved. And he gave those to the Son. And of course, the Son was incarnated into human flesh and lived and was crucified, died, was buried, and rose again from the dead. And that's when our sins were forgiven. That's when we were justified at the cross. All of our sins, past, present, and future were dealt with at that moment of time at the cross. And of course, some date that to April the 3rd in 33 AD. There may be some dispute about that, but that is a popular time when people have said it happened. Okay, so the covenantal agreement between the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit was made in eternity before the foundation of the world. And we can see that if we were to read from the epistle of Ephesians, and I will just read a couple verses here, and this is in Ephesians chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ, accordingly as he had chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself, accordingly to the good pleasure of his will. So we could see there that our salvation started before the foundation of the world. That would have been before time began. Now also, if someone to ask me, well, does that mean that we were born saved? No, we were not born saved. We were born spiritually dead until we were quickened by the Holy Spirit, where the scripture says in Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 1, I believe, you who he hath quickened, who were dead in trespasses and sins. So prior to the time that we were quickened or regenerated, and when I say regenerated, I mean that the heart of stone was taken out and a heart of flesh was put in us, okay? And that happened by immediate Holy Spirit regeneration. And it is able to be done sovereignly by the Lord without any assistance from man whatsoever. Now, that's one of the differences that we have between eternal salvation and temporal salvation. If there is anything that you have to do regarding salvation, then it is temporal salvation. Repent, believe, water baptism, things that are ifs or conditions or something you have to do, all of that is based on works and therefore is temporal salvation. That is salvation in this life. And so, let's see. I want to read a couple more scriptures here, just showing some of the differences here. We're going to read out of 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 18. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. So all the aspects of our salvation that are seen, our sanctification process, our obedience, reading of the word, water baptism, all of these things that are seen have to do with our temporal salvation. And that is why the gospel is preached, is that men may be converted in their minds because they have already been born again. The gospel doesn't save you. A decision doesn't save you. What saves you is the Holy Spirit and the living Word of God, not the written Word of God or the spoken Word of God, but the living Word of God. So let us read now from Hebrews 5 and verse 9. And being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that obey him. Other scriptures that we could look at, when Jesus was talking to Nicodemus in chapter 3 and verse 3 of John, he says, verily, verily, I say unto you, you must be born again. And this birth is from above. We cannot birth ourselves spiritually no more than we birth ourselves in the flesh. John 3:8 also is a good scripture speaking of the Holy Spirit, how you can see the evidence of the Holy Spirit just as you could see evidence of wind blowing, but you don't know where it came from and you don't know where it is going. So that is temporal and eternal salvation. And of course, if someone were to ask me, well, if we are predestined and we were saved outside of time, then why do we preach the gospel? Well, not only are we instructed to do so by Jesus himself in a couple of the gospels, that being Mark and Matthew, but it is done to educate and to enlighten the minds of those who are saved so they can walk in obedience and grow in the Lord. You know, it's just like when a child is born. You don't just leave them without educating them, without training them so that they could mature as adults. The same situation happens spiritually. We don't birth ourselves. We don't choose to be born no more than that, you know, whether I'm born in the United States or South Africa, whether my skin is white or whether it is black, who my parents were, I had no choice in that matter, nor did I have any choice in the matter if I was going to be one of God's elect or not. So I am, of course, eternally grateful that the Lord did elect me. My spirit bears witness to the fact that I am a child of God. And one of the things that I would like to look at is in 1 John and 5, in verse 1, really quick here. And the reason that I'm able to say that with confidence is whoever believeth that Jesus is the Christ is born of God, and everyone that loveth him that beget loveth also that is begotten of him. So I do believe that Jesus is the Christ. I believe that he is God come in the flesh, and a person who is not born again does not believe that. They do not bear the fruits of salvation in their lives. All right. Like I said, if you want to know more about eternal salvation and temporal salvation, check out Pastor Henderson's video. And if you want a 14-page article to read on it, to learn about it, check out Elder Gowan's article on that. And so, God bless you. Have a good day and enjoy yourself. Bye-bye.